I'm sure you put items in favorites, frequently used sites. But in Edge browser, there's another feature called collections. So what is the difference and why should we use it? How do you add anything to favorites? I'm going to a website and I know I'm going to refer to this site very frequently. That's the time I click on the Add to Favorites tab. Now, when you do that, a common mistake is we keep the name, and when you add it, it's going to occupy so much space. So I can only accommodate few favorites in this favorites bar. So the correct way to add favorites is to delete the name. As long as you can remember what this icon means, you're good. Instant access to frequently used sites, we use favorites. That's clear. Take a moment to look at the favorite sites I have. This is Outlook, this is Teams, this is Wikipedia, Video Indexer, Netflix, ChatGPT, and Microsoft Blog. These are frequently used sites, but they are not related to each other. I just need one-click access for these sites, that's all. Think about it the other way. Suppose I have a set of sites which are related to each other, and when I work on them, I need access to all of them. That means there is a common topic. That topic is not something I do frequently, so I don't want it in favorites. Otherwise, my favorites will get too crowded and multiple topics will get mixed up. That is where we use collections. So how do you create collections? Click on this button and start a new collection. So let's say I'm learning Power BI. I'm going to upfront create a collection to keep sites related to Power BI. Okay. Now this pane need not always be open. I can close it. And let me go to a site containing something to do with Power BI. So this is a site I need to work on. So I will come back to it when I'm working on Power BI. So now right click on it and say add page to collections. I already have Power BI collection, so I add it there. Now let's say this is another place where I'm working on. Again, right click, add page to collection, Power BI. So that's how now I'm building a set of related sites for Power BI. Let's say I've added multiple topics there. I can go and look at the collection. So I've created a collection containing 5 sites related to Power BI. By default, those sites are not seen. But when I'm actually going to work on Power BI, imagine if I had added those 5 sites in favorites, I would have to click 5 times to open them. So I go to collections. I can see the Power BI collections, which contains 5 sites. I can right click and say open all 5. This is how collections can be useful in the context of a topic. Also notice that this created Power BI as a group here. So this is a tab group. Now let's look at another scenario related to Power BI. I have learned Power BI, but now I'm an expert and I teach people Power BI. So when I'm teaching my audience Power BI, I need a different set of links from where people can download Power BI and another set of links which contain data sets. Now I'm going to create another collection called Power BI Training. And quickly, I'll add some content to it. If this pane is open, I can directly click Add Current Page, which is faster than right click and choose the collection. Now, one more method to add multiple items is open all the related items, right click on the tab and say Add All Tabs to Collection. And in this case, I'm going to add it to Training. So now I have two collections. If I'm conducting a training, I'm going to go to this collection and say open all. Now let's say during the training I need some reference about Power BI. I already have my Power BI learning collections, so I can quickly open that as well. And notice it's color coded because they are two different tab groups. So this is the convenience of collections. When do we use it? Learning and research related sites about a particular topic. You have a set of products and your competitors you want to monitor. So you don't want to go to each competitor page again and again. Create a collection called competitors. Another one is demos. I deliver sessions, demos. All the related topics should be easily available in one click. One great thing about Edge, once you log in, you have a profile. And when the profile is syncing, it will actually synchronize all the collections across devices. Suppose I'm doing lots of trainings and I use this browser and this particular profile only for training purpose. Now, when I open this particular profile, I'll get a blank tab. I don't want that. I want these tabs to be automatically opened. How do I do that? Keep the tabs open manually for the first time and then go to settings. In settings, we have start. And here I can say pick up all the currently open tabs and use them. So now all these things are going to be my default tabs. So now I'm going to restart the browser. All of them opened automatically. In a collection, I may want this list to be sent somewhere else, so I can put it in Excel, OneNote, and Word, and each of them have a purpose. If I just want a list of topics and their URLs, then Excel is a good idea. So it created an Excel file for me containing the links. If I choose OneNote, it'll ask me which notebook should I put it in, and then it'll add a new page with all the links. It'll also include a thumbnail if possible. If this was for a research paper or a report where you want references, you can actually add citations. I'll choose the format of citations, and each one of them I have to complete. You will either see a cross or an exclamation mark. So go to each one of them. Wherever there is mandatory, you'll have to fill it up. Now, because these collections are used more for researching a topic, you may also want to add some notes right there. So favorites, collections, and startup pages. Three ways of accessing things which you need frequently or related topics quickly. So start using it. There is another thing which you may find very useful called Immersive Reader. I have already created a nice video on that. Have a look at it. So that's it for now. Thank you.